Hello everyone, welcome back to the Domino Bricks YouTube channel where we create custom LEGO sets, minifigures and more. Today we'll be taking a look at my Zack Snyder's Justice League custom figures, and if you do go on to enjoy this video, feel free to like and subscribe, it does go a long way, but let's just get into it, starting off with Superman. Now let me just start off by saying, usually I do around 16 to like 12 or 16 figures if we're doing a CMF series, but for this I decided to go for 6 figures for each member of the Justice League, but these are some of my most detailed figures yet, so do go on to enjoy them. It is a shorter video, but I'm super proud of the figures and how they turned out. So, starting off with Superman here, he is in his black suit, obviously. He has printing throughout the arms, legs, torso. Everything is brand new, including the face print there. It's a combination of multiple different Superman face prints. He uses the dog trainer hair in black, and all of the silver accents are in a metallic color. For some reason, the shininess of the metal didn't come through on the render, but I assure you that they are there. He also has the Superman suit texturing on it. I'll throw up the texture on the screen so that you can see it more clearly. Once again, didn't show up that well in the render. I really don't think the render did this justice, but no matter how I changed the lighting, it just didn't turn out as well as I wanted it to. I'm still very proud of it though. He does have the detailing of the boots and the wrist gauntlets, and his House of El symbol just turned out so brilliantly in my opinion. And he is one of the most simplistic figures of the series, but I do really like him. The next figure in the series, I wanted to do a Batman figure, but I checked through everything that LEGO have done for the Josh Whedon Justice League, and to be honest, I thought the Batman figures they did were really great, and I looked everywhere, and apparently they didn't do a Bruce Wayne, so I took it upon myself to do that. I've gone for more of a rugged look here. He has a like black trench coat on, his shirt's unbuttoned, and he has the stubble all across his face, like he does throughout the most of the movie. He has a chrome batarang there as his accessory, pretty much, I think, one of the only characters in this series with an accessory. He once again has the dog trainer style hair, but this time it's special. It is dual molded. It has two different colours on it, with dark grey leading into the black to show his age, as he has been Batman for 20 years in the Justice League films. And yeah, this is the least detailed figure in the series, but I really enjoy it. I think it does look like Ben Affleck's Batman throughout the film, so this was really fun to make. Next up we have Aquaman, and this is definitely one of my favourites in the series. He just turned out so brilliantly. I put so much work into those tattoos on his chest there. I tried to make them as accurate as possible, and he has the necklace thing with the green jewel there, as you can see. His trousers are pretty simple. They just have a chain going from the belt to the pocket, and he has obviously the Aquaman hairpiece we have seen before. Brand new angered face print. Like, I didn't realize this, but most of the figures in this series do look rather angry, which I think was cool because it matched the darker tone of the film. He has tattoos all along his arms, and he has some leather wrist gauntlets there. Once again, kind of simple, but I thought the detailing on the tattoos was really fun and definitely one of the most interesting things to design in the series. The next figure in the series is Cyborg, and I didn't know what to do because obviously throughout the film you see he has those visions where it's him in his varsity jacket for Gotham Athletic, and I was going to do that, but I decided to go just with Cyborg. Now, this does use a lot of the assets from the official LEGO Cyborg, because I think that was just such a good minifigure. But I have chromed out the whole figure, and I've changed a lot of the design on the torso. There's not much on the legs, because I think those legs were just really well done. The arms are all me, very simplistic, but I think they do look great, and I have given him a brand new mold for the Cyborg helmet piece there. It's just thinned out more because I think the original was way too clunky and didn't really match the film, and he just has the regular Cyborg head there, but I really love this, and if LEGO would ever do a chrome Cyborg figure, that would just be so incredible to me. This next figure is a really cool one, and that is Wonder Woman. Now, I stripped the Wonder Woman figure that they have down to its core, like just the basic colours, and I created whole new colours for this. Like, the red on the torso is much darker, to match the gritty kind of look she has in the film. It uses a variety of different golds and stuff, even though it doesn't really show there. She has a brand new face print with just some changes to the gold headband, and the dark blue on the skirt piece is also brand new. As you can see there, the boots are way more accurate now, and they wrap around all around the figure. The gauntlets on the wrists are brand new as well. They are just way more detailed and they match the film more than the regular plain silver ones. And finally, my absolute favourite figure in this entire series, and probably the most detailed figure I've ever designed, and that is the Flash. Now, Ezra Miller as a Flash, I was never a huge fan of in the original Justice League film, purely because I'm such a big fan of Grant Gustin's Flash, but I really enjoyed him in the Snyder Cut. I thought it was really funny, and I just thought, I have to do this. I have to make a series just because of Ezra Miller, and I really wanted to do a figure of him. Now, you may look at this and think, that's not much different from the one that LEGO released, and believe me, it definitely is. I might put the two side by side on the screen so you can see the differences there, but I am such a big fan of how this figure turned out. I darkened down the reds so much. He has patterns all over the legs, which just turned out absolutely perfectly, especially with that dotted pattern on the side. He has arm printing, finally. I didn't like how there was such a lack of arm printing in all of the figures they released for the Justice League film. So it was a real blast to add arm printing to people. I used so many different colours, and I decided to do a little bit of like shading and texture changes on the torso. I'll throw a picture of that up on the screen as well. He has a brand new headpiece, but due to the cowl, you can't really see it. I did change the colours and stuff, and I just think this turned out absolutely incredibly. I could not have asked for a better way for it to have come out. It is just some of my best work, and I am extremely proud of it. I have to say, it was very good to make a series where it's less figures but way more detail, especially with that Flash figure we've just seen. I really enjoyed just taking my time with all the figures and making them as perfect as they could possibly be. If you have enjoyed these figures, once again, feel free to like and subscribe, and you can go and follow me on Instagram at Domino Bricks. I now have a full account for that. And I have been getting a few requests for like people wanting me to sell my figures and my sets and stuff, but as of now, I'm not at a point where I can do that. But if you do want my stuff to come out at some point in the future, feel free to like and subscribe once again, just so that I can have the incentive to make my stuff a reality. That would be a really cool thing to do. So yeah, just it would be real helpful if you could support the channel. But yeah, I hope you've had a great time watching these videos, and have a nice day.